When her now 3-year-old son, Reed, was 14 and a half months old, Jennifer Petit thought he had come down with a cold.
4 or 5 days into it, he tried to stand up at the table and fell. And then by the end of the night, he was completely paralyzed from the neck down.
So they took him to the emergency room, where he was diagnosed with pneumonia. But when they got back home, his symptoms worsened.
His cry was off, he wasn't making tears, he was sleeping a lot, and it really literally felt like I was watching him die.
They returned to the hospital.
2 to 3 days before they actually were able to diagnose it.
The diagnosis, acute flaccid myelitis, a mysterious, paralyzing illness that affects the nervous system, causing the muscles and reflexes in the body to become weak. The CDC says the number of cases are continuing to grow.
We have now confirmed 90 cases in 27 states, and there are an additional 162 cases that are awaiting confirmation or are under investigation.
The CDC says it's still not clear what is causing some children to lose the ability to move their face, neck, back, arms, or legs.
Acute flaccid myelitis, or AFM, is a very serious, but also a very rare condition. Since 2014, when we first started tracking this phenomenon, we've observed that on average, less than 1 in a million children are affected by this condition.
Today, Reed can scoot on the floor, but must use a wheelchair to get around. Reed's mom says doctors have told her Reed won't grow out of AFM, but should continue to improve, though they don't know by how much.
Nobody really knows. There really is no prognosis for these specific kids.
Marina Hutchinson, The Associated Press.